My channel, if you don't know, my name is Kurosh, and I've been basically having this laptop, this Toshiba Satellite L55A 5290 for almost 2 years now, but the keys have been like they haven't worked for a long time now, and I've been using like external keys over there and stuff. But today after a tough 10 days, I got a keyboard for my laptop and it just arrived from China. So today I'm gonna show you how to change your Toshiba L55TA5290 satellite keyboard, how to change it and everything. So basically, first thing, by the way, this is me, hello. First thing you have to do is to completely shut down your computer. Yep, you heard the sound. And now I'm gonna try to place this right here so that you can see what I do. Okay, so first I need to, let me get this out of the way. Okay, perfect. First we have here, it's from a Chinese company, I really don't know. I put the link to the company, like to the website that I bought this from, down below if you guys are interested. But first, let's open this bad boy. Okay. Over here we have, so this is the box. Over here we have the keyboard. So China, you can see it's very high quality. By the way, this video is not sponsored or anything. Yep, you can see it. It's not black, but still, I wanted the keyboard so bad that I bought it, so it doesn't go with the flow of it's not original, basically, but you can see it's the identical keyboard. Okay, so now how to switch the keyboard. So here we have the laptop back again. Basically what you have to do is that you have to start from one side. Okay, this is better. You have to start from one side and try to basically pinch it with your hand. Then you can see that it pops out like this. That's not bad. Just try to push towards yourself at the top, or to the other, like to the opposite side from the beginning, so that the pins come out. And yeah, I already disconnected the key, like the thing, so that cause basically W and K and 2 didn't work. And because of that, I disconnected all of the keys so that it doesn't interfere when I put the keyboard on it. But now, basically, I'm gonna show you how to detach this keyboard and then attach the other one. So, basically, to attach or detach this key, you can see that over here. Sorry if it's too shaky, but there are two pins over here. One is on this side, and like these black things over here, you have to pull both of them out. See, one is out, then the other one. You have to pull both of them out at the same time. So like this, and then you would plug in the thing while these keys are out, so that it would completely go in. Let me see. Yeah, I'm gonna try with the other one, but basically to get them out, that's the same concept, but over here, I'm gonna try with these keys and try to put them in like this. So you can see that this one, they're the identical keys, and then you flip them around. So basically you have to flip this one. Oh, you have to flip this one to over here so that doesn't bend when you put it down. But basically what you would do is that you would get this, go over here, be like, hello. Oh dear. Yeah, this is not the easiest job in the world. And I'm gonna try to put the camera somewhere else. Sorry. And try to get a support for it. Alright, so now you pull both of these out. No, that didn't work. Let's see again. Interesting. Did you hear those two? Yep. So basically now this is in. Now I'll just flip this around. I'm basically now did attach it back in. But before putting it completely in place, I wanna turn on my computer to see if this actually works. You can see the keyboard, the keys are correct. What does the fob say? No, sorry, that wasn't. Yeah, you can see that over here. The light went out just now. But yeah, the light turned on over here for number lock. And I think it goes pretty well with the flow. It's not as good as black, but still, it's fresh. Alright, so I'm gonna wait for this to load up and then check to see if the keys are working properly. There are probably. Yep. And let me see, what was the name of the company? Okay, yeah, it's a Chinese company. Chinese products are not necessarily bad, guys. Like, in the comment down below, leave your opinion about what you think about Chinese products, but I don't think they're bad. It depends on where you get the product from as well. Sorry, it just doesn't want to stay stable. Yep, and then to put it in place, you can see all of these over here. You just have to shove them like this. And then basically push hard so that everything goes in place. I don't know why there is that bump over there. Oh, there's a bump because of these. Oh dear. Alright. Alright, so moment of truth. Here you can see, like, you can hear all of these. And you can see that. Or actually, let me first sign in and then I'll show you. Yep, and you can see that it works properly. The only problem over here is that you have to get these two pins out of here, which I think it's doable. You have to just be so careful about it. But yeah, you can see one is over here, one is over there, because this one, you can see that over here, these two places are patches. I mean, not patches, they're not patches, they're just holes. But these are patches, so just watch out for that. But I'm gonna go to Word to show you that every word, every key works perfectly. And even the key travel feels to be like the amount the key travels feels to be a little bit more, so that's good. That's always a plus. And so, all right, over here, and then you go to you type here. I'm actually gonna bra. Wow. There we go. That's QWE. What are these ones? You can see all of them work. And I know what is going on with my Spotify. But yeah. Actually, now that I'm seeing here, there are patches over here, so you can basically get these out and put these in place of them. But I'm not sure if I would do that. I might just try to get rid of them by like cutting them with something. But yeah, I was Leo. Thank you for watching. You don't need to watch all of this. I'm gonna put the place where I... Alright, never mind. Bye guys!